There's something cruel about Rafael Nadal. The way he makes you feel like you have a chance of beating him on clay. Sometimes he leaves the door open. Maybe a break point here and there. You see a slight ray of hope through the entrance and you come in. Before you know it, he shuts the door and you're locked in the dungeon. He starts whipping you with the forehand and then he crushes you with the backhand. And when you're too numb to even ask for mercy, he goes medieval on you, Game of Thrones style. Chatrier Court. There's something Machiavellian about Rafael Nadal. He knows Dominic Thiem is his main rival at the French, so he let him beat him twice. It gives Thiem a boost of confidence. He thinks he can beat him now in 5 sets. So when he steps on the court against Rafa, he's got something to lose. And the pressure catches up with him. It is pure evil genius.
We've been doing this for years.
Of course Dominic Thiem has the shots, and he probably has the fitness. But does he have this? And more importantly, does he have the cojones? There is something unreal about Rafael Nadal. What he has done at the French Open is beyond belief. 10 titles. 10 titles in 13 years. 85 wins against only 2 losses. One of them against Novak Djokovic in 2015, where he was playing out of this world. So that doesn't really count. The other one was 9 years ago to Robin Soderling, and he still can't figure out how he did it. There's something mythical about Rafael Nadal. When he enters the center court on Sunday, he has a unique opportunity to win his 17th Grand Slam title and, get ready for this, 11th French Open title. If it wasn't for the Swiss maestro, there wouldn't be much of a debate about who is the greatest of all time. Let's put it this way. Maybe Rafa's not the GOAT, but he's certainly the GCOAT, greatest competitor of all time.
Chatrier Court.
He's also the GOATOC, greatest of all time on clay, and the GSOAT, greatest Spaniard of all time. And finally, sad but true, he has succeeded both Rod Laver and yours truly, the self-appointed commissioner of tennis, as the GLOAT, GLOAT, greatest lefty of all time. And I'm not going to be gloating about that one.